Student, in our today's session, we are going to learn about the some terms describing the UV absorption. Terms like chromophore, auxochromes, bathochromic shift, hypsochromic shift, hyperchromic shift, and hypochromic shift. Look into the figure. Here, the y-axis is absorbance. Versus x-axis is the wavelength, and here what is that lambda max? Lambda max means what? Here this is the point where maximum absorption occur. If in this Gaussian shape of peak, here the point where maximum absorption occur and the wavelength correspond to that is called lambda max. The wavelength at which maximum absorption occur is called as lambda max. Okay. Now we'll move one by one. First term is chromophore. Functional group that gives the electronic transition. It is an isolated functional group, a covalently unsaturated functional group, which is capable of absorbing the UV radiation, is called as chromophore. Chroma means color, phoros means bearing, color bearing functional group which is capable of absorbing UV radiation. A covalently unsaturated group. Some important chromophore like NO2, N double bond O, N double bond N, C double bond O, C double bond N, C double bond C, C double bond S, etc. So chromophore means the isolated functional group which is capable of absorbing the UV radiation. Okay, next is the auxochrome. What is that auxochrome? Substituent with unshared pair of electrons like OH, NH, SH, etc. When attached to chromophore, they generally move the absorption maxima to longer wavelength. They shift this absorption maxima towards the longer wavelength. So here what is auxochrome means? A functional group, a saturated group with non-bonded electron which does not absorb the radiation longer than 200. That means they absorb below UV region, but when attached to chromophore cause the shift of absorption maxima towards the longer wavelength. When they attach to chromophore, they cause shifting of absorption to longer wavelength. Next most important again is the bathochromic shift. What is that bathochromic shift? It is also called as red shift. It involves the shift of absorption towards the longer wavelength. It is shift of absorption maximum towards longer wavelength because of presence of certain groups like OH, NH2, or we can call auxochromes, or by change of solvent. What is that bathochromic shift? Look at here. This is the bathochromic shift. Here the shift of absorption maxima towards longer wavelength. Shifting of this maxima towards longer wavelength is called as bathochromic shift because of attachment of auxochrome or by changing certain solvents. That is bathochromic red shift. Shift towards the red region of the visible light. Next is the hypsochromic shift. It is opposite to bathochromic shift. It is called as blue shift. What happens in the hypsochromic shift? The shift of absorption maxima towards the shorter wavelength, maybe because of the removal of the conjugation in a system, is called as hypsochromic shift. Here look at hypsochromic shift. Shift of this absorption maxima towards the shorter wavelength because of the removal of conjugation or because of removal of that auxochrome or by change of solvent, it shift the absorption maxima towards shorter wavelength. Next is the hyperchromic shift, hyperchromic effect. Hypsochromic shift is called as blue shift, shifting towards the blue region of the visible light. So it is hypsochromic shift. Next is the hyperchromic shift. Look at here, shift, hyperchromic shift. What happens in hyperchromic shift is the effect which involves an increase in the intensity of absorption. It increases the intensity of absorption, and it is because of the introduction of an auxochrome. So look at here. Here the intensity of absorption increases. So it is called as hyperchromic shift because of the introduction of the auxochrome. And opposite to that is the hypochromic shift. Hypochromic shift, here the decrease in epsilon of a band. Epsilon is the absorption. So decrease in the intensity of absorption is called as hypochromic shift, and it is because of the distortment of the geometry of the molecule that causes the hypochromic effect, hypochromic shift. Okay, so in today's session we learn about different terms describing the UV, that is bathochromic shift, then the chromophore, bathochromic shift, auxochrome, hypsochromic shift, hyperchromic shift, and hyperchromic shift. Chromophore is the functional group which able to absorb the UV light. Auxochrome, they generally do not absorb the UV light above 200, but when attached to chromophore, they are able to absorb the UV light. Bathochromic shift, it is red shift, the shift of absorption towards the longer, shift of absorption maxima towards the longer wavelength. Then hypsochromic shift, shift of absorption maxima towards the shorter wavelength. And hyperchromic shift, here the intensity of absorption is increased. It involves the increase in the intensity of absorption. And hypochromic shift, here decrease in the intensity of absorption. These are important terms regarding UV visible spectroscopy. Thank you.